dress I have to wear in the going to office. Okay, in office what subject I have to teach? Okay. Every mundane thing she said. Everything is taught by taught. Then Ramana Maharshi, did he talk about anything on self-inquiry?
No.
Okay. Nothing. Anything in Nirvana?
No.
Everything her own subconscious mind is projecting and talking back. Then she asked me, why Ramana Maharshi has told me to come to you? This is a big question. Then I told her, next time when you meet Ramana Maharshi, please ask him to teach you self-inquiry, Atmavichara, and ask you, tell you how to remove Triputi. Seer, seeing, and the process of seeing, Triputi is there. How to remove that? If you ask that question and come back to me. So far she has not returned. Because the question and answer is coming from her own mind. Subconscious mind is asking question, conscious mind is also taking some input from subconscious mind giving answer. Your behavior will change when your conscious mind is able to give back the answer from the guru's teaching. This is the meaning of bring guru in your heart. Understand? If you keep on talking to the subconscious mind with the same input what you have, your life will be like that only. Are you clear? This is the meaning of Vidyas. Guru doesn't give NSCF teaching. He is giving teaching based on the Vedanta. Alright? A logical way of talking back. Your self has happened. Then what will happen? Your mind will become starting and silent. Bring Guru into your life means this. Bring the teaching of your Guru into your mind. And the subconscious mind will keep on talking some nonsense. Bring sense into subconscious mind by talk back. That's called contemplation, Nididhyasa. Now the question comes, what is manana? That's Ramana, you understood now?
Yes.
Manana means understanding. Means my life has to change. So now this class I said, this is all realization, this all is over. No more realization, this is realization. Now you go back. Oh, I am realized today. You can put a date also. This is the date I got enlightened also. But that delight doesn't work that way. When you start applying in your life, the moment you see your husband, the moment you see your wife, you are back to your normal self, not a realized self. You are down to earth from heaven, you have gone back to earth. From 21st floor, you have gone to ground floor.
Your dream continues.
You get dragged into a dream. Now the question comes, either my understanding is not complete, my relation is not complete, there is some experience I am missing, so this doubt will come. So now you have a standard reference, okay? Like basically mind will come, look for a reference now. So there must be reference. If I am realized, I should be like this. First reference is, if I am realized, I should be sitting in Himalayas. So that doesn't seem to be practical. If I am realized, I should have one round of aura in my head. That also doesn't work. Okay, if I am realized, at least I should have a beard. Whatever beard, the hair itself is going off. So you have some vague references in your mind. Okay? So Guru understands that. These vague references. So he gives a gold standard for reference, gold standard for your reference. Because you have a lot of superficial standards. A dress, the way of behavior, the way of looking, walking. Okay? So Guru says, if you are realized, your behavior will be like this. Your understanding will be like this. He gives some reference. That is actually Shloka Abhagavadita. Stita Pradna Lakshana. Dukeshu.
Dukeshu.
Anudignamanaha. Sukeshu. Vigataspraha. Vitaraga. Bayakrodaha. Sthitadi munirucchate. So Sri Krishna gives a sign of realization. Your concept of sign of realization is a dress. Your concept of sign of realization is a behavior. Your concept of sign of realization is some lifestyle. Sri Krishna's concept of realization is inner changes.
Poise.
Inner poise. equanimity in all situations, life, happiness, unhappiness, no attraction, repulsion, okay, raga, dvesha, bhaya, krodha, anger and fear disappears. It's not for showing somebody, deep inside you. So this is the standard against you valid. So manana is, my life, is it in accordance with the sthitapradna life? Okay, manana is that. Has my life become accordance to sthitapradna life?
Close loop control.
This is called manana. Okay, understand, manana means not repeating that scripture 10 million times. Manana means, have I reached this sthitapradna lakshana? There's nobody to give a certificate to you. Nobody will come and give a, I mean, I'll give a certificate to you, okay? After this class, all of you are enlightened. Because to put an end to your search, this is enlightenment, okay? Understanding is enlightenment. Because otherwise you start looking, oh, I want to experience. So manana means, I have a gap between my understanding and my behavior based on sthita pradna lakshana. Otherwise you'll put a gold standard. Oh, a person is realized, just by waving his hand, somebody dead person should walk. Okay, or do like this, some vibhuti should come. Or do like this, at least Mysore Pak should come in the hand. Okay, so you have a wrong references. A right reference is given to you by Guru for evaluating, self-evaluation, not for evaluation by anybody. That is called sthitapradna. So your life, you are constantly evaluating against sthitapradna. There is a gap, of course. Naturally, gap will come. The gap will not come because of understanding. Understanding is over. The gap will come because of the earlier programming. So that earlier programming you have to correct through manana. That means, now deep-rooted teaching, you have to again and again sit, I am Brahman. The objection will come. So correct it. Objection will come. Correct it. So gradually you are moving towards the sthitapradna, almost. Understanding is realization. Behavioral correction is called nididhyasa. Is that clear? Any questions?
Understanding is realization.
Behavioral
correction
is nididhyasa.
Nididhyasa. And the closed loop is the manana.
Manana. Gold standard, reference standard. Reference is sthitapradna, not external reference. Internal reference. Are you understanding?
So the behavior has to sync with the realization.
No. Realization is that one only. Behavior has to be corrected to sthitapradna. That is the purpose of nididhyasa. That is the purpose of sahaja samadhi and manana. Every day I keep on giving talks. The talk, nothing new is there. But this will address the question from various angles so that the understanding becomes clear and clear. There's no more understanding. This much only. Entire Vedanta is summarized in this class. Over. This is only for you to strengthen that. And manana is your behavior has to change as per the this thing, what you call as sthita pradna. Nididhyasa is the gap is not in understanding. Gap is not in experience. Gap is in the behavior. Are you clear? The behavior is because deep programming for you is I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect. You go and correct that. Now instead of I am the body, you teach your subconscious mind. I am Brahman. Are you clear? Is it clear to everybody? Arthaya? Doubt here? Shravana mana nidhyasa vartakodaya? Realization is that. Realization is this much only. Even Buddha, Ramakrishna, Paramahamsa, everybody realizes this much only. Okay? This is realization. But their behaviors are different depending on the impressions. Some of them may correct the impression or some of them may leave the impression. But realization is this much only. Degree of correction you bring in the realization, impression, is the amount of time you spend in nididhyasa.
Pregnant. What is pregnant?
Pradna is called pratyakshadna. Hmm. So
in this context, how pragna is?
Pradna is pratyakshadna. Pradna is pratyakshadna. Pratyakshadna means whatever is available to you, experience is pratyakshadna. Hmm. So you be aware your behavior. So somebody calls you donkey. So your subconscious mind says, you are Brahman. So your pradna says, okay, fine. So you behave like a donkey. Pradna says, Okay, you are behaving like a donkey, correct it.
Prajna has to completely overtake Jnana. The Jnana is what is coming from subconscious, Prajna is coming from actual
Jnana, knowing. Jnana is coming, Prajna and Jnana, the conscious mind has got Jnana. So Prajna has awakened. Earlier Prajna was sleeping, Prajna was going with the subconscious mind. Now he has awakened Prajna, has to correct the subconscious mind.
So the Nididhyasana is kind of will erase the subconscious impression.
Right. To the extent possible, you do it. Don't overdo it. See, there's no point in overdoing it. Okay?
Also enjoy India Pak match.
Also enjoy India Pak. So don't overdo it, okay? Because you have to keep a very high standard. Thinking that I should be like Ramakrishna Paramahansa, I should be like that. Don't have to become. You keep your standard, what is comfortable to the level of behavior for you, do it. At least to the extent that make the life of husband or children peaceful. At least they should come and thank me for... Guruji, what you have done? Thank you very much. If they give the thank, that I think is that level of conscience sufficient. Don't have to go off at very high standard. Right? Do that extent possible. Don't overdo it. Little bit as you do Nidhyasa. Vasanas will get clear. Your subconscious mind is a good servant, but a bad master. Okay? So, there was a guru, one ashram. Shishyas bought one gorilla, one small gorilla, baby. So the baby gorilla grew up all with the other Shishyas. It learned many things. It used to do all household work of ashram very beautifully. Bring water, okay, bring wood, everything. And it used to do a lot of service to the guru. Very powerful. Well, it was brought, it was only a few kgs. And it grew up into 504-pound gorilla. Very big. Right, but everything it does very cleanly. When he cleans the floor, it does much better than any shishyas. Everybody is very happy with the work. One day, guru is sleeping, very hot summer. So this gorilla is fanning the guru with a fan. One fly comes and sits on the nose of the guru. It chases. The fly goes, again comes back. Chases, comes back. The gorilla gets angry. It takes a hammer and smashes that fly. This is exactly our subconscious mind. You have taught many things to that. You have to reteach it based on the right understanding. This is called Nididhyasa. Are you clear? Any questions? Too much, too heavy for today? Okay, so when the guru teaches, I told you who is guru, who is Sadguru, and who is Karana Guru. When the guru teaches, there should be some authentic teaching. Otherwise, you will not believe. So anybody can come and say, I have realized something. There are many people, right? There are many followers also. It will keep coming. Everybody thinks everything is right because they don't know what is reality, because they have not learned. So authentic teaching has to come. Authentic teaching comes from Vedas. So that authentic teaching, we can't read so many Vedas. There are so much Vedas, okay, lakhs and lakhs. Then there are so many rituals. I can't do that. Then summary of Vedas is in Vedanta. I have studied so many these things, so many questions, so much. It's very nice. Still I have not realized. The summary of Vedas is Vedanta, Upanishad. Summary of Vedanta is Vakyas, four Mahavakyas. There are many more Mahavakyas, but four Mahavakyas are taken to give you confidence that this is the summary. Others, what happens, you think something else is there. Okay? And they are chosen from four Vedas because, you think Rigveda, if you told Rajveda, something else is there. Samaveda, something else is there. Something is missing. See, the mind always puts a doubt. To give you confidence that nothing you are missing, the Veda teaching is only this much. There are four Vakyas are chosen. One from Rigveda, one from Yajurveda, one from Samaveda, one from Atharvaveda. To give you confidence that this is the end. Veda, Anta, finish. So otherwise you keep on searching for something more. You want to stuff with more information. More information will not lead to transformation. Only clear understanding will lead to your transformation. Okay? Otherwise what happens? We keep on stuffing with our head. So to end the knowledge, end the search for knowledge also, the search for knowledge also is to be ended. These four sentences are given. First is called Pradnanam Brahma, awareness is Brahman. Okay? It comes from Aitareya Upanishad, Rigveda. Pradnanam means awareness. So awareness is the ability to know, knowing ability. Say for example, this chair does not know me. I have the ability to know. The TV, the screen, there's something is there. The TV screen doesn't know me. I can know. That means knowing ability is called consciousness. Okay? The knowing ability is called Pradnana. Okay? It is more than Jnana. Pradnana. Jnana means knowledge. Pradnana means more than knowledge. Knowing ability is not knowing ability. Jnana is knowledge. Application of knowing ability is called Jnana. Right? So Pradnanam Brahma. Brahma means infinite. The infinite existence, consciousness, bliss is called Pradnanam. Okay? And what is that? Who is that? I. Not this I. The real I. The I am Brahman. You understand? Ultimately, you have to, Brahma, you have to replace the word called I. Until you replace the Brahma with I, you won't understand. Otherwise, you start thinking Brahma is somewhere. I am Brahman. I am pure awareness. Now, the pure awareness doesn't mean that you know everything. It only means you need to know nothing. There is nothing to know. Your knowledge has ended, finished. Because when you are everything, there is nothing for you to know. Okay? This is exactly the meaning of a jnani. He knows everything. Means he knows nothing. No, jnani means for us very clear. What is my future? At least tell me whether she is, my daughter is getting married or not. Whether my daughter is, my son is getting good marks or not. There is nothing to do with prajna. That has to do with the my ability of the mind called telepathy. Pradnanam means pure awareness. A jnani does knows nothing. Because he doesn't need to know anything. There is no urge to know anything. He has come to end of knowledge. Have you? The search for knowledge is ended. Okay? So the three limitations, time limitation, space limitation, and karma. Okay? The time limitation, as the limitation because the body is called space, a space limitation. So I am infinite, I have become limited. Okay? Now I am timeless, I have become bound by time. Then I am bound by karma, a cause and effect. Okay? Then I have forgotten I am Satchitananda. The infinity portion has become three limited. Satchit portion, consciousness portion, I want more and more knowledge. I keep searching for knowledge. Right? Chit, I am not satisfied with chit. I want to have no knowledge because knowledge is power. This book I read, that book I read, this workshop I go, that workshop I go. Keep on searching for knowledge. Have you come to end of knowledge? You will come to end of knowledge when you realize that you are the knowing ability. Knowledge is the application of that. You understand? The knowing ability is Brahman. Once you realize your true nature, your desire for knowledge also falls. Right now you have desire for listening to more scriptures. Shastra Vasana is there. That means the thirst has not gone. Once you get Atmadnana, that thirst will go. That's why for that Jnani, Vedas say, Vedaha Bhavanti Avedaha. The Vedas become useless. Knowledge ends. Search for knowledge. I am the source of knowledge. Application of knowledge can be many. I am the nature of knowledge. Jnana Swarupa. That's called Pradnana. Are you clear? So pure knowledge, pure awareness. I am Shiva. Right? When they happen, everything is just appearance in me. All knowledge is just application. So then this is called Pradnanam Brahma is called Anubhava Vakya. It's an experience. Who's Anubhava Vakya? Who's Anubhavakya? Sadguru. Sadguru has realized Pradnanam Brahma. With that he has become peaceful. Now he, Shishya comes. Shishya is suffering. So he teaches him Tattvamasi. You are that. You are finding yourself as limited. You are not limited. You are infinite. Tattvamasi. So this is called Upadesha Vakya. This comes from the Chandogya Upanishad Samaveda. One is Guru has Anubhava, Pradnana Brahma. Shishya's teaching to Shishya is called Samaveda, from Samaveda. Now, Shishya contemplates. Aham Brahmasmi. Now, you have to sit. Shravana is over. Shravana is over. Now, Nididhyasa it does. I am Brahman. Because the program is hello. Yeah. Sorry. Yeah. There are another half an hour class will be over. Okay. Thank you. So now Shishya has to contemplate on that. What is this? Shravana is over. Nididhyasa has to do. Aham Brahmasmi Nididhyasa has to do. Why has to do? Jnana is over. You are Brahman. But he needs a behavioral correction. That's why Nididhyasa. Nididhyasa is not for realization.
I am Brahman, that is correct, but I am awareness is again Brahman, right? That is again awareness is because it's a reflection of Brahman, right?
No. I am is a reflection of Brahman. This is I am is a reflected consciousness. This is telling I am Brahman. I am pure consciousness. Right now you are speaking of I am Robin.
Like the knowing principle.
Knowing principle, no?
That is the ability of the mind, right?
That's the ability. No, knowing the principle is the ability of the mind which has come from pure awareness. The pure awareness part which is reflected in the mind has associated with the body. I am the body, it's saying. Wrong understanding. The right understanding, I am not the body, I am pure awareness. Is the correct understanding.
And pure awareness is same as Brahman.
Yes. So, the awareness which has appeared in our body is called consciousness or Chidabhasa. So, that is wrongly associated with the body. It has rightly associated with the source.
But does pure awareness pervade even the store? Brahman will provide stone.
Everywhere. The stone, everything. Brahman only is there. How Brahman is only is there? Next class. Right? Otherwise, next class will happen in 2 months, no? If my students disappear, what do I do? I have to give something interesting next class, no?
two months for Varna and Nididhyasa.
So, you understand now? This is what has happened now. The student has to sit and he has the earlier impressions are coming. I am the body, I am the mind, I am the mind, right? That impression he has to correct. I am Chaitanyam, I am consciousness. And he has to give proper logic to that. Mind accepts logic. Okay? So this forcing won't happen. Forcing is day by day I am becoming Brahman, day by day I am becoming Guru. Tomorrow, sometime in life I will become Brahman, sometime I will become enlightened, sometime I will become liberated. Then you are giving wrong inputs to that. So you should not say, I will become Brahman one day. You should say, I am Brahman. You have to assert the truth. No, one day I will be enlightened. One day something will happen. One day it will never come. Because you are giving wrong input to the engine, machine called mind. Right? So, then what will happen? The correction will happen. He is doing meditating. I am Brahman. Nididhyasa is doing. So that Nididhyasa, that's called first is Upadesha Vakya. Second is Sadhana Vakya. Sadhana. He is doing Sadhana. Okay. Sadhana is not for realization. Sadhana is for correction. Please understand. This is very different. Others will do think that 1 million years I will do meditation, I will get realization. It's wrong. 100 million years if you meditate also, you will not get realization. You get realization only when you listen to the truth from Guru's this thing. You understand it, clarify it, and that's all is the end. After that, whatever you do is for behavioral correction. So what happens is, a very mature seeker, before he comes to the Guru, he would have done lot of sadhana to behavior correction. That's why he is shamadama, titiksha, uparati, shraddha, samadhana. That maturity has come. For him, if Guru teaches tattvamasi, is over. But most of the people today, they don't have adequate background preparation. So for them, they have to do nididhyasa, because a correction has to happen. Are you clear? So this called, first is called Upadesha Vakya. First is called Anubhava Vakya, second is called Upadesha Vakya, third is called Sadhana Vakya. Okay? Next, I am Atma Brahma, this self is Brahman. Now he has recognized, myself is Brahman. Okay? Now he doesn't say, I know Brahman, I have this thing. Myself is Brahman, he is recognizing. Right? Myself is Brahman. That's again Anubhava Vakya for the Shishya. Okay? So like that, four important vakyas are taken from four of the Upanishads to give you confidence that all the Vedanta summary, Vedanta teaching is this much only, nothing more. If you keep on searching for reading something, then it becomes Shastra Vasana, it doesn't lead you anywhere. Understand the summary very clearly, realize the truth, understanding is realization, that is the end. Okay, that understanding has to integrate with your day-to-day experience. That requires a correction in your behavior. That requires a nididhyasa. The reference for that is Sthita Pradhana Lakshya. Any questions?
All this is still in the dream.
Yeah, everything is a dream. But in dream, you wake up and realize that everything is a dream. In the dream, many times you understand this is a dream. See, Brahman doesn't require anything from the dream, the relation. The dream character requires some relation. The dream character suddenly realizes, oh, this is a dream which is going on. I am really Brahman. So now that what will happen, that experience which are happening in and around will lose their significance, impact. They start, the same thing which used to hurt earlier will hurt less, because it's said anyway dream hurt. Same thing which used to give you a lot of exploding joy will not give you, because you will become peaceful and equanimous in the dream. As long as the body lasts, you continue to be there. Because body has come out with a expired date. Till that you will last. You will become jivanmukti. While alive in the body, you will become mukti. Will happen only when you are alive. That's why mukti is also dream. That's why last teaching, for me neither bandha nor mukti is there, from Atma point of view. But bandha appears to be there. That apparent bandha is removed, apparent knowledge. Any questions? So the more you bring this knowledge into you, the more it will dissolve the ignorance, more and more stress and strain of life will reduce, because deep inside you become equanimous. And because deep inside you become peaceful, you become one with the universe. Then what will happen? The whole universe will start cooperating with you in some ways. You are no longer individual. Okay? So what happens is that it's like this. When you eat food, mouth will open, the stomach will secrete some juice, everything is working together. When you thought you are individual, the Brahman took a limitation of individual. He said, in this game, nobody should help me. Okay, I want to play myself. So no more help will come. You want to have struggle, you want to this thing. So now you start becoming dissolved, you are becoming Brahman. Then everybody starts coming and helping you. You are no longer individual. You don't have to ask. The whole universe will start working. Your thought will become universal thought. So they start, a lot of things will happen. That people call as miracle, that people call as siddhis and all. But this person is not bothered, because he is not an individual. He just is peaceful. Are you clear? And he has no specific wills and this has to happen, that has to be. He has no choice. That choice will come only for the individual. So I am realized, I have a good dana. So I have a body pain. I want to heal this, then you don't have dana. Because now you have become individual.
So the sadhana of aham brahmasmi will dissolve everything and that light, whatever.
Yeah, it's previous impressions.
Previous impressions.
Okay. So either you come from dana, where all impressions are clear, your shama, dama, titiksha, uparati, shraddha, samadhana, everything is over. You are just pakwa. You come to Guru, dana, tattvamasi is over, then he goes back. For him, nothing is pending. Okay? But if you are not come with the full pakwa, then you have to continue till the awesome thing. Right? So there are two types of sadhakas. Okay, one is very mature. I'm just giving you how jnana itself is liberation. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa was doing Kali Upasana. He was worshipping Kali, seeing Kali, talking to her, giving food. Then one day Tottapuri comes, Guru Tottapuri comes. Tottapuri comes and he teaches him Tattvamasi. Teaches him Tattvamasi. Then says, cut Kali, not physically, through jnana. Like this, whatever is seen is not you. Cut it. Then he is established in jnana. So 21 days he sits silently. So then, so many days he sits silently. Then over. Then now he is no longer able to do puja of Kali because everything is self only. Right? So then, to the extent that he wants to give argyam. So Sandhyavandan he used to do. Argyam he wants to give. He can't even take hold of the water because there is no longer, the mind is no longer seeing the duality. So then, Tottapuri calls him, come. Let us sit and again contemplate on Aham Brahmasmi. I am Brahma. Ramakrishna says, why? Why should I do that? Okay. And Tottapuri says, see, Tottapuri had that kamandala, water. See, this kamandala will get dirty, no? I have to wash it every alternate day. Otherwise, it will get dirty. Like, mind is like that, it becomes dirty. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa says, surprised. What if kamandala is golden kamandala? Will gold get dirty? So for Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, one tattvamasi teaching, meditation is over, matter is over. After that, no meditation is required. The teaching is realized, over. Okay? The behavior also changed. Because before that teaching, he has already done enough. That's what tradition Vedanta says, Shama, Adama, Titiksha, Upardhi, Shraddha, Samadhana has to happen. For a pakka sadhana. Most of the time that doesn't happen because of whatever reason. But they get a fortunate to get a good guru, great guru. So the teaching happens, they get a clarity. Then they have to continue to change their behavior. That's called Nidhyasa. Otherwise, Vedanta teaching is very straightforward. Shravana Matrena Nana is listening, understanding, matter is over. Then why Nidhyasa? He is to just correct the behavior. Any questions, sir?
Behavior
Sean?
Changes is
Nididhyasana. Vasana, sir. No. You already told your mind, I am the body. Okay, I am 80 kgs. I want to become slim. So, IIS. That IIS has to be replaced with the silence, Brahman. Are we clear? Any questions? So, if you have an understanding that, I got jnana, I have to do something for realization, that understanding is wrong. You have to do nothing for realization. I got jnana, my experience, I have to get some experience. No. Because Brahman has not got split into one experience or other experience. No. Brahman is a seamless experience. Okay. One experience, can it make in Brahman? No. Cannot. But my behavior has to change. Yeah, you can change it. Or you can leave it also. Right? So, if you think that I have to become live like a Sthira Pradna, you correct it. No, I have got jnana enough, is okay, enough. And those people who leave whatever is condition is called avadutas. Their behavior will be not fitting into society. They say, okay, I got jnana. How, whatever way I am, then I am there. No vasana karshi. Is it correct? Any questions are there so far? Are you clear now? Any doubts?
So Nididhyasana basically is correction. It cannot be silence, total silence also. It's only when anything comes sprouts out, you give the correct.
Okay, correct answer is what? Any thought will come? Just with respect to your identity, you know. So if you are mother, child, what is my child doing? Okay. If you are a wife, what the hell my husband is doing? So some thought will come, some identity. Now you say, okay, this identity is okay, this is a mithya. Real I am, really I am. Self. Gradually that identity will. Okay. So for Atma, neither Bandha nor Mukti. So what is happening is the illusionary mind has come. The illusionary mind has illusionary concept. Illusionary concept has probably correct concept.
Free.
Free. right? So if somebody had some brilliant experience, some wonderful experience, yeah, it can happen. I'm not saying the experiences cannot happen. There can be experience, some fantastic experience can happen. But these are all something once in a while. It doesn't repeat. Many of the experiences come from vasanas, impressions, previous life vasanas or previous vasanas. So you
but
don't
notice time bandbidutana previous vasana
alla adu nimge heltara adu time anta nimge explain madodre helakala andre don't crave for it, something comes don't
I'm not getting excited
with
that,
right? So can be something along with that happen, but you don't have to crave for it. How I want enlightenment experience. So I heard Buddha had a mind blowing enlightenment experience, and people said Buddha's head got split into million pieces and some light came out of his head. So many explanations are there in the literature, but none of them are, they're all metaphorical. Okay.
One of the Ganeshas, what you sent, Ramana Maharshi's. Remember that story? He goes and tells Ramana Maharshi, I'm not, I've left that world and now.
Yeah.
He goes back and he comes back to say, is this that experience? I always had that in my mind. Yeah.
So, enlightenment is not a fantastic experience. Okay, enlightenment is a fantastic insight. Okay, all these days I was thinking I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect, I am husband, I am wife, I am none of this. I am conscious. That insight, if it comes, emerges very clearly to you, that's called enlightenment. Understand? So many times enlightenment be associated with some experiences, sometimes wonderful, sometimes magnificent, sometimes, but all experiences are mithya, temporary. That depends on your previous vasanas, it may come, right? Okay, in fact I start with a fantastic experience, then I realized the experience is not very important, but when I started I had a mind-blowing experience. So that was the point. Then gradually all this truth started coming because of my whatever sadhana I have done earlier, something appeared. Okay. Any questions are there? Now shall we postpone sarvam kalu ida brahma to next class? But that takes another 2-3 hours. So
Prabhuji, are you going to talk about Vedas, Veda Rishis, Veda?
What about it?
Vedas, each Veda has got some Rishis. And
yeah.
We are going to
talk. Now, what is the question?
In Rigveda, some Rishis comes under Rigveda.
No, see, they're all, see, that's all not important.
Scripture.
See, these are all, that Rishi is, the concept of Rishi is to give you authenticity. Okay, authenticity. So, I went to this thing, what is that? I studied in IIT. Wow, you studied in IIT? To give you confidence that it's great. So, these Vedas and Vakyas are coming. Rishis are considered as authentic and great people. Name of the Rishi, X, Y, Z,
doesn't matter.
It only tells you, it is an authentic source, not Tom, Dick and Harry, date. Okay. So there are many Rishis, Vashishta, Vishwamitra, there are many Rishis, and there are many Rishikas importantly. There are 64 Rishikas, there are more 64 women Rishis. Okay. Alright. What we need here is men Rishis only. There are, in Vedas, there are many women Rishis. There are more than 64. So all of them has gone to background. The purpose is not, see, they are all very important. In the very initial stage, to give you confidence that Vedas are authentic, Vedas are right, okay, they come from authentic source. Now you have come to a stage, yeah, Vedas are authentic, I agree, Rishis are great, I agree, finally what I have to learn? Only this much. Okay, come to the point. Now who are not come to the point? They need a lot of focus required to bring him to the point. They are all bringing him to the point. Now you come to the point. What is the point? This is the point. Right? Now if I start telling you the earlier stories, you say, what do I do with Rishis? You'll tell. Right? So they are all required to, as a part of the confidence building in the society, as a part of the confidence building in the authenticity of Vedas, confidence building in the student. Yeah, this is very important. Okay? Listen to this. Now I think all of you have gone beyond that stage where confidence about Vedas or confidence building about Vedas is not a very important part for you. Right? I didn't even take life of Shankaracharya, I didn't even take life of Madhvacharya. They're all for motivation, confidence building, all those things. Now, this class is not about confidence building. That all is done by all the people outside. So this class is, okay, I have got a confidence, Vedas are authentic. I have confidence there is something called self-creation. Now, how do I get there? What is the point? This is the point. You are coming to the point. Any questions? No questions? Next class, in September. By that time, you do some good amount of... July and August, I am traveling. So next class will be in September. So by the time, do a good amount of nididhyasa. Don't come back and say, what is that I have to realize? Please tell me, what is that? I didn't get a realization experience. Some gap is there. See, I studied the book, this wonderful autobiography of somebody. Okay, it says, when enlightenment means some light came into his head, or somebody saw the light, what happened to my head? So don't come back to me. Do some nididhyasa and correct your... try to become moot towards this Siddhapadna Sthiti. Right? Shall I do something?
You mentioned your experience initially. Will you share it with us?
Yeah, I can share. Huh? I can share. But the only thing is I don't want to do it because it should not cause a lot of...
No, we will not expect that. It would be nice to know.
It should not cause you
no.
This thing, right?
The wanting of it.
Idea.